my pleasure to welcome you all to Mind Rocks. This is the fifth edition, first time in Kolkata. And as I said, we'll probably make it happen every year here. Now, Mind Rocks is all about, actually, the name suggests it very clearly, to actually rock your mind, right? But there's another angle to it, because a lot of people think and believe, and I think they think right, your mind is also dictated by your heart. I was a little skeptical about this whole position of the heart and the mind, but then Kali convinced me this morning to say, probably it's mind rocks and heart rocks. Kali?
Yeah, I agree. I think we're always making decisions which are either based on our mind or on our heart. And I find that more often than not, my decisions are based on my heart rather than on my mind. And I think those are the best decisions. But I would like to say one of the nicest things about being young, and this is one of the things that people didn't tell me when I was growing up, is that you have choices. So please use this opportunity, use your youth to make the choices, right ones, wrong ones, with the heart, with the mind. Use those options.
Ladies and gentlemen, our first speaker today for the very first edition of Mind Rocks at Kolkata is someone who's scripted box office success in just the last few months. I'm sure all of you here have seen the film adaptation of his book, Three Mistakes of My Life, Kai Poche. Give me a loud cheer if you have. That really was a no-brainer considering the number of people who already started hounding Chetan Bhagat. So without further ado, can I please call on stage Mr. Chetan Bhagat.
I can't really say there are no mistakes in life. There are some mistakes in life. There are some stupid things we do and we shouldn't have done them. And there are some mistakes which are not really mistakes. People think they are mistakes. You think you are a mistake, but actually it helps you a lot. I think there was a bad first book. The first book I wrote, which never got published. Actually, it was 5.1 only, but it was very badly written. It was just not interesting. It was just dull, stupid. And I felt very bad when it was rejected. But in a way, I'm very happy I made that mistake. Because it was reasonably good also, no? If it was like, it was really bad. Like it was 1 out of 10. And if it was, say, 6 out of 10, and it had got published, it would have not done well or done okay, and it would not have been the phenomenon of 5.7 theme. How many of you saw Hello? How many of you liked it? Okay, I know. You're looking for 4 people in India who have liked it. If you really have, then, you know, and I know some of you are just raising your hand because he's the speaker man. How can we like it? No, we didn't like it. But the most of you put it down. We didn't like it. So it didn't do well, and nobody even talked about that movie when they introduced me. They say Three Idiots, they say Kai Poche. Because obviously people talk about successes more. But to me, Hello means a lot more than these films. In Hello, I just took it too casually. I was still working in the bank, and I was doing my third book. And I really thought I could pull it off. I could keep working in the bank, I could keep writing books, and I could also help out in movies while I'm working in Hong Kong. And I thought it's possible. And it wasn't. The biggest thing Hello did for me, it made me leave the bank. I was not willing to leave my job. I was thinking about it, every day I used to think about it, but Hello's failure in some ways made me decide that, listen, if I don't give attention to this, I can't take it for granted. You know, today the films are suffering, tomorrow the books may suffer. So I finally quit. So it was a great mistake I did. Hello is a mistake in the eyes of the world, but to me, it is a very good mistake I've done. Kai Poche was a huge risk. When you take a risk, that's not a mistake, you know. And that's the confusion people have in India. People feel if someone's taken a risk and it has not worked, that's a mistake. It's not. We only judge mistakes on whether those things, efforts were successful or not. But it's not a mistake if it was a risk and that didn't pay off. You know, but luckily it paid off, so it became a good mistake.
When I was a kid, I mean, as far back as I can remember, I didn't want to do anything else but become an actor. So I had grown up watching all these megastars that we have today, you know, Shah Rukh, Aamir, Salman, Akshay, Amitabh, Anil Kapoor. So I've watched all these movies like Hum and stuff like that, and I used to grow up thinking that always thinking that मैं तो actor ही बनूंगा. My earliest memory of a performance was at a birthday party in suburban Bombay, and it was a slow birthday party, and there was music playing, and my dadi was sitting there, and the entire family had gone. So there was this big garden, and there was one chair with my dadi on that chair, and she said, "I'm getting bored. You dance for me. Just do something. You amuse me." So there was music playing. It was a song that I don't know if you remember, "Jumma Jumma De De." अरे जुम्मा मेरी जाने मन बाहर निकल आज जुम्मा है आज का वादा है देख मैं आ गया तू भी जल्दी आ मुझे मत और तड़पा अरे तू बोली थी हे पिछले जुम्मे को हे जुम्मा दूंगी हे अगले जुम्मे को हे आज जुम्मा है तो आजा 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 सर तुम्हारे उसूल तुम्हारे आदर्श किस काम के हैं तुम्हारे उसूल तुम्हारे सारे उसूलों को गूंद कर एक पत्ती की रोटी नहीं बनाई जा सकी रवि जिन आदर्शों के लिए तुम अपनी जिंदगी भी खेलने के लिए तैयार हो क्या किया उन आदर्शों ने एक 400-500 रुपए की पुलिस की नौकरी किराए का क्वार्टर ड्यूटी जीप दो जोड़ी खाकी वर्दी देखो ये भाई मैं हूँ ये भाई तुम है हम दोनों एक साथ ही फुटपाथ से उठे थे आज मैं कहाँ आ गया तुम कहाँ रह गए मैं कहाँ आ गया आज मेरे पास बिल्डिंग है बैंक बैलेंस है तुम्हारे पास क्या है अखा दे कचोरे सुरमा बचोरे लग दे छुछोरे बड़े हाय फाय दिल पे तराती साडे चल जाती मारे दिल को लाटी पूछे वाए वाए चाय में डूबा बिस्कुट हो गया
सही बस विद द हैंड एवी 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 लुट गया एवी 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 लुट गया
Okay, come on, rapid fire. First thing that comes to my head, right? Okay, restart, I'm ready.
Girlfriend.
Fun.
Committed. One night stand.
Had them.
Current status.
Single. Hi.
Hello. Sorry, wrong number.
आपल्या कॉल करे आहे फिलहाल उपलब्ध नाहीये
नाहीये नाहीये रिलेशनशिप
शो
नो हाइपोथेटिकली
मैडम हम गुने हैं एक बार जिसके साथ जी लिए मरते भी उसी के साथ
So, we have a question for Bradley now after this series. Been watching the cricket, mate?
Well, firstly, hello. Bit better Hindi, so namaste. Very nice to be here, but yeah, look, Australians haven't been playing their best cricket, but you can't take credit away from India. India have been playing some beautiful cricket, and to win 4-0 on this... environment over here, which is tough for the Australians to come over and play, but they've done an extremely good job.
Nikhil, do you think things would have been different had Bradley been on this tour?
Well, absolutely. You know, we played the series on tracks that were turning from day one, but not because Brett is sitting next to me, but airspeed is airspeed, Kunal. You know, on even these tracks, when you're bowling at about 148, 149 kilometers an hour, airspeed is airspeed, and you know, we used to get that ball to reverse thing as well. I'm sure, you know, maybe the results wouldn't have been different, but he most certainly would have made those victories a little more difficult, I'll tell you that.
Just in two words, George, what is the main reason for this downfall in Australian cricket?
You get to the stage where, you know, a lot of the senior players move on. I've moved on, Ricky Ponting's moved on, Mike Hussey, Mr. Cricket's moved on just in the last 12 months. So, you get to a stage where Australia now are going through a rebuilding stage. So it's going to take time.
Cricket is a gentleman's game.
Why sledge? Play the game in the right spirit.
I think you like to use the word sledge, and we call it gamesmanship. And you can have a laugh, but there's been plenty of times when I was playing against VVS Lakshman one day in Perth, and we're very, very, you know, good close mates off the field, and he was batting, and I was bowling a few bounces, and he kept the balls going past his nose, and I walked down to him, and I said, with no emotion on my face, I said, "I've just worked out what your name stands for." He looked at me, I said, "Very, very scared." And he instantly laughed. The commentators think that we're having a sledging contest, but it wasn't the case. And it's not always what you think on TV, you know. And we know for a fact that there's one person in the world that you don't say a word to, and that's a great Sachin Tendulkar. You just don't sledge him. Just bow and, you know, and try and bowl it.
In this crowd, we have lots of Manchester United fans and Chelsea fans, Liverpool fans. I'm an Arsenal fan. I don't know why, but I am. So, do you think this is good for Indian football that people are watching all this? Or do you think it's bad because what they're seeing on TV, I mean, you know, what they see live will never compete with that?
I think it's got good and bad points to it. The good point is that a lot of the kids would now, you know, idolize David Beckham or Wayne Rooney or Cristiano Ronaldo or Messi, and they would, seeing them play, I think they do come out of the house and go and play football.
I would feel that if I've spent enough time with someone, either I should say it's not working for me or it is working for me. And if it's working for me, I give it everything. And if it's not working for me, instead of dilly-dallying, I'll prefer to move on to something else. But again, that's me. But I have many friends who don't subscribe to that at all. Like on Facebook, you can see people are just liking everything. So I think it's more of a like generation than a love generation. We all like options. We always want to latch on to the newest gizmo. And so I have a phone from a very long time ago, so I don't necessarily need to maybe latch on to the latest thing. But I know that a lot of people appreciate that kind of, you know, options and choices. And a slightly wiser, older female role model in my life once told me that you should one should never actually marry the first person that they are intimate with. And she said, well, actually it gets really complicated because love is this kind of weird chemical reaction. It's actually just about hormones. And then over time you will realize and be able to make a distinction between that kind of gooiness that you feel. And love is not just about the gooiness, it's about other things as well.
Just to talk about relationships, I've been married for 7 years now. Or is it 8? My wife is going to kill me. I've been married for a long time now. And I'm married, yeah. Yeah, I have 2 children. Yeah, so I don't know what I'm doing at a youth summit, really. I've been with her for 18 years now, and it's been wonderful because what happens in those years is that, and I don't think that like many young people get to experience this, is that you get to see a person change, not only, you know, like you get to see them grow, you bond with them and then you kind of rediscover your relationship. And I mean, I was mentioning this to you earlier, but I don't know how many of you agree, but I think that Manmohan Singh is partly responsible for young people being the way they are today. A hush goes around. No. I'll tell you why, because I think that what happened in the early 90s with the opening up of the economy and with the massive foreign investment coming in and big companies and all these media and these cameras flying around in the sky and things like that. What happened during this time is that the young people got energized into wanting more. And not that it's a bad thing, it's a good thing. We all want better lives, you know, but I'm saying that some of it is misplaced. Some of it is driven in the wrong direction. Like they're trying to sell us houses with golf courses and we don't play golf here, like a lot of us. I don't play golf here, but like they're trying to tell us things that just don't make sense, you know. So I'm just saying that in that process, what happened to young people is that they wanted to experiment and they want the next thing and the next thing. And as Soha was saying, like the BlackBerry she's been using for very, very long, but it's not what young people want. They want a new phone. They want a new iPhone 5S 7000D or whatever. I think that is damn important for young people to experiment. to try new things. I think it's very important for young people to be sexually open and, I mean, safe, very safe, you know, but what's wrong in trying, like going out with many different people? What's wrong with if a girl wants to go out with 3-4 guys before she gets married? Nothing. Nothing in my mind. And what if she wants to go out with another girl? It's okay. You know, for me, I got married for two reasons. One was to keep my parents and in-laws happy. And the second was because you get a lot of gifts. Yeah. Me and my wife kind of sustained ourselves on the gifts that we got for 1 year. We were able to manage just on gift money. It was wonderful. So I would recommend it to you if you're looking to start out. Like, get married, you get a little bit of cash here. It's damn nice.
To be a politician these days is not a very good thing. I don't think we are in a very good place. When I got into Youth Congress, you know, Subir Babu is here. When I got into Youth Congress, I'm 34 years old. In Northeast, we don't look very old, you know. So now I'm in Senior Congress. I'm no longer in Youth Congress. When I got into Youth Congress, I came to Kolkata for the first time. My first assignment was in Kolkata. I met a man. He had no hair left in his head. He was walking in a danda like Ranveer had come, but that is for a different reason. He was 63 years old. He was Youth Congress. His grandson was my age. And he was supposed to be my contemporary. Now, I see there's an effective change. Not only in this party, in all parties. Youth are getting more active. You can't fool anyone anymore. People, I want to say one thing to you. If good people don't want to enter politics, we should stop complaining about bad people ruling us. Yes, it is very difficult. It is very difficult.
Chini tumare ogo videshini tumi thako sindhu pare ogo videshini ogo videshini.
Mind, 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 rock. Mind, 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 rock.